Welcome to episode 2 of Chat Adda, powered by 24.7 Sports. Chat Adda is all about candid conversation with Indian athletes. Today on board, we have Harmit Desai. Harmit Desai is a table tennis player and he ranks second nationally. He won 81st national championships last year and have won several other tours for India all over the world. Let's get in conversation with him.
Hello Harmit. It's my pleasure to invite you on 24.7 Sports. I would love to know why table tennis. I mean, tell us something about how you ended up playing table tennis, and at what age did you start playing table tennis?
Yeah, first of all, thank you to 24/7 for inviting me or to interact with you to have a chat so that people can know more about table tennis or more about me. So thank you for that. And yeah, I started table tennis at the age of 6, and it was because of my father. He brought a table tennis table at home to play with his friends, and also for my elder brother. And I could hardly reach the table's height at that age. I was too small. And by seeing the table, I was very fascinated about it because it was something new in my life, and I even didn't know the name of the sport, or it was considered to be a sport. So I really didn't have any idea about it. But when I saw them playing, I was really fascinated, and then I wanted to give it a try. And I was a very stubborn kid, so I started trying because I just wanted to try it out. And they always used to tell me that you need to grow up before you can try it. And I went to my mother and I didn't stop trying. And then they let me play for some time. And then I picked it up really well. And my father was the first coach of mine. And I was really fortunate that the PT table was at home. And my first competitor used to be my mother. So they used to come back home from office around 10, 11 in the night, and I used to be tired, or they used to be tired coming back all day, having so much of work. So when they used to come, I used to have a match with my mother. We'd be 11 in the night or 12 in the night. I used to wait for them, and that's how the last game was supposed to be my victory. That's how I used to stop playing table tennis in the night. So I had the passion for table tennis, and I have been really fortunate that I got the kind of parent I have, that they supported me throughout, and they understood that a game would be a thing that I wanted to pursue. Because back then in Surat, table tennis was not that popular, or we didn't have sporting culture in our city, because Surat is considered as a business hub, textile city, or a diamond city. So to become a TT player from a city like this is really hard, was really hard, not anymore, because now there are many more facilities by the government or the municipal corporation, and many players are coming up now. So it was much harder back then, and also in the schools it was really hard because they didn't support in terms of attendance, because I had to travel a lot. So I had to change many schools, around 8 to 9 schools during that time. So it was really hard times during that time, but I also liked to study on the other hand. So I was really good at managing both at the same time.
Right. So as you said that there were less facilities available, or there were no facilities available in your city for table tennis, or there was not such awareness about table tennis in Surat. So I remember what I know is Surat from Surat. Manav Thakkar is also from Surat, right?
Yes.
So when did you meet him first, and how is your bonding with him?
So he's almost 6 to 7 years younger to me. I think he's 7 years younger to me, and I was already playing for India when he started to play table tennis.
Right.
I was playing in the under 15 level during that time, and maybe he started at the age of 5 or 6. I don't know, but something around that time. And I saw him first when he was around 7 or 8 years old in a district or a state tournament. So there were coaches around, and there were also some players. They used to say that he is the next big thing after me. And I was really happy to see players coming from my city. And also there were many players after me who played for the state team, because it was really difficult before me. There were not at all a single player who played for the state team in the senior category. So it used to be a big thing to represent state from my city. So it was really a big thing, and also few players then went on to play for India. So I'm really happy that the grab has been really good for the state and for my city, and I hope that it continues in the future. And also now Surat is considered as one of the strongest cities in table tennis in Gujarat. Okay. And Gujarat is also considered as one of the powerhouse in table tennis. It has started to grow. So I think that in the coming times, I hope that if the trend continues, it can be one of the hub in table tennis, like it has been in business or in textile or in dining. So I hope that it happens like that in sports too.
Right. And what do you think is an achievement for you? Among those achievements, which achievement is like you remember, you will remember it for your lifetime?
I would say that I had never thought that I would ever reach at this level, because the day I started, I would enjoy playing table tennis, and I still enjoy doing that. So the results kept on coming in, and I'm really happy. I'm grateful. I'm thankful to everyone who has supported me, and the things have turned out the way it has. So I'm really happy about it. But also there are things that I had never thought of, because like Arjun Award, it has been one of the highlights in my career, because every player dreams about it.
Right.
Every sports person from India dreams about getting an Arjun Award. Getting
you received it last year, right? You received it last
year.
Yes,
2019. Yeah.
Right.
So to get a recognition for your efforts from the government is a really big thing. And it gave me a lot of confidence, a lot of motivation to do even better, to work even harder. And that has helped me to even win Indonesia Open just after Arjun Award in a couple of months. Or also I went on to win the national championship. So these were the really big moments in my career, winning the Commonwealth Championship in also 2019. So the last 9 to 10 months have been really great. And if you could consider, the last 2 years has been absolutely fantastic for my career. So
it's a turning point for you. Turning point.
Yeah, it has been a turning point, and all the hard work has paid off. So I started playing table tennis in 1999 when I was just 6 years old. So it's almost 20 years now, and it feels so good that all the hard work is being paid, and also it's paying the right dividends.
Right, right. Congratulations for winning that 81st national championships at held at Hyderabad. So yeah, I can see that kind of feeling that you have after winning that, and at the same time that winning an Arjuna Award, then Indonesia, going for Indonesia Open, winning over there, then going for national championships and being over there. So it's a kind of the graph is going up. Like it's continuously reaching at the top. So I'm so happy, and congratulations for that.
Thank you.
So usually whomsoever we meet from table tennis background, everyone says that their role model is Sharad Kamal. So Sharad Kamal have been a legend in table tennis for India, and he's recognized all over the world. So so is he your role model, or is there anyone else you admire?
Yeah, no, he was my role model since I was 12 or 13 years old, and I first met him when I was just 8 years old, and he was not that big name during that time. So he has been the same guy what I saw him the first time. Right. He's so humble, he's quite grounded, he's down to earth. So I have learned a lot of things, and when I was 13 or 14 years old, I just wanted to be like him. I wanted to achieve at least some of the things that he has done for India. So the passion he has for the game, the way he has continued over these years, he has a very long career. He is around 38 years old now, yeah. And he's still playing at his best. So he inspires most of us, and especially me. So he gives me a lot of inspiration and motivation to prolong my career, and I hope that I can also serve my country for the coming years, and so till the age of 40 or so. So that's my wish. Yeah.
Going further, we have noticed that you have been very calm on the court. So how is Harmeet outside the court? So inside court he is very, very calm and cool. How is he outside? And we have seen you have started cooking, and you have started doing all those stuff at home. So how is it?
Yeah, I'm also calm outside the court, but I like to make fun with the friends. I make a lot of jokes, and I'm quite a jolly person, and I like to hang out with my friends, but that's not possible right now during this situation. But I have been picking up some new skills right now. I have been doing some things like learning to cook from my mother, because most of the time I am staying in Germany to train. So this is the only time where I have been able to be at home with my parents. So I am trying to learn to cook things. When I'll be going back to Germany, I can also cook myself the ghar ka khana, the ki dal. So that's what I have been always missing. Right. So I'll be able to take few things from my mother's recipe, and also I'm learning to play piano. I used to like a lot. I learned few songs before, and I have been I haven't been able to continue that due to my busy schedule, and now I've got that opportunity. So I'm also doing a lot of this kind of things. I have been also learning German a bit, because I travel to Germany, and I like to learn different languages. So that's a part where I haven't given a lot of attention to. So now in this lockdown period, I've been doing that. And also on a lighter note, my mother always says that she doesn't want the lockdown to end, because she gets the time to stay with me. So I don't complain about it. Yeah, I also like to be with the family, but on the same time, I also want to go back to the playing days, to play for the country. So that has been the biggest dream of my life, and I want to continue doing that.
I have got one more question, or maybe one more favor I would like to get it from you. As you said, you have started singing back. Can you just sing one or two lines for us?
I don't sing well. I just can play keyboard, because I am really bad singer, and I have never practiced singing. Okay. I also don't sing for myself, because when I hear myself, it's terrible. So I never try to sing, but I just play piano. I have also posted some of the videos on my Instagram. So that's what I like, because I know what I can do, and the singing part is not for me.
Right. Okay. So going further, what would be your next goal in the coming days?
My next goal normally is to qualify for the Olympics, and I don't know regarding the current situation, if it will be conducted in 2021 or not, or what will be the future, what it's quite uncertain right now. So I'm just continuing to train at home, doing my workout, and also I have a tiki table at home because I got a help from the Surat Municipal Corporation to transport it from an academy to my place. So I'm quite thankful to them, and also I've been daily practicing 2 to 3 hours of practice so that I can keep myself in touch and also prepare myself for future tournaments. But I don't know if the Olympics will be the next thing, if I'll be able to qualify for that, or if the Olympics will be conducted. But I keep myself positive for 2022 Commonwealth Games, where I would like to win a singles medal, and also I want to get into the top 50 of the world rankings. My best was 60 in the world rankings, so that's my next goal. And also, if not possible in 2021, I would like to qualify in the 2024 Olympics. So that's my goal for now.
Right. Great. So all the best for all these goals that you have kept. Yeah. You have set for you. What do you think is the role of your parents in this sporting career? Like you, as you said, that your mom initially used to help you out with to get trained for table tennis or to get into table tennis. But at the later stage, once you have entered into a career where you are representing for Team India at international level and national level, at such point of time, what is the role of your parents?
Actually, I started representing for India at the age of 12, and still my father and mother, one of them at least, used to accompany me in the tournaments till the age of 16 or 17. So they have accompanied me, and my father used to be always there during my training sessions. He used to wake up before me. So yeah. I used to wake around 5:30, he used to wake 5 o'clock to get the things ready and everything, so that I am in the training mode all the time, and I don't have to think anything else apart from table tennis or studies. So it was quite a healthy and sporting atmosphere at home. Everyone were quite focused and very much disciplined towards the goal. If I had to follow a diet or a regime, they used to follow with me so that I don't have a bad impact on my thinking. So if I had important tournaments, or if I had to manage my timings, so they never went for parties or social life, or they also sacrificed all those things just because of me, that I would never feel that I am not able to go, but they are going. Right. So they always did for me all those kind of things. They never went for movies, even I didn't went. But always, sometimes when you are young, you don't know the importance of sport sometimes, and you tend to get fascinated by other things also, like going with the friends for movies or stuff. But it is really important for an athlete or for a sports person to be disciplined at all times. Mm-hmm. And you start to later on understand the importance of being disciplined, or following the right timings, or following the right schedule. So that's how my parents have helped me, and also my mother has studied nutrition. So she has been my dietitian all throughout my career. So she has helped me to stay healthy. She has helped me to stay away from the junk food or the foods that are not appropriate for the athletes. So I have been helped a lot by my parents, and I'm grateful that I got such kind of parents. Without them, I wouldn't have been able to reach at this level. And I also remember that the table tennis hall, what I had at that age, was one of the best in India, I would say, because we had the international level of height, the space, also the table was international standard, we had the international level flooring. So no one would ever think I was still a state level player, and at that time my father used to think about being an international player. So his vision was there. He always wanted me to have the best kind of facilities so that, or the conditions to practice in. And that's what he has given me. He never thought of doing something lesser or giving me lesser. So he did whatever he could and he gave me the best things possible.
Right. Next question is, there might be many difficulties that you have faced during your career, right? So when you come across any problem or when you come across any difficulty during your career, you might have faced. So how do you tackle such difficulties?
Yeah, I think it's quite normal for every sports person to have difficult situations, or it's quite, I think, for every sports person there are lean patches or the not so good times where they are lack in form or they suffer from some kind of confidence. But I have also had the same problems in my career and I have learned to deal with that. It is very important for every sports person to reach at a high level. One has to be very positive, and I have been negative during some times, I remember, but I have always never given up. I have always tried to come back. I have analyzed my game, always tried to give more hours in the practice hall and also work on my weaknesses. And there are things what you need to work on. Always there are things, even for the world champion. So you need to update your game style. You need to update yourself. You need to talk to coaches. You need to talk to other people to find different perspective or different things in your game. So that you can learn things, you can understand more about your game, and also you can try to implement and practice, start implementing. And also then you need to give a lot of hours. So that's the key points, I think. So sooner or later, the results start to come in. And that's how I look towards these things.
Right. Okay. So as you said that you received a great support from your parents' side, but from the academic point of view, were you good at academics, and what were those positive impacts? Like you said that you have changed 8 to 9 schools just to focus on your sports. So what do you think, see, there was negative impacts on your sports, you had to shift your schools from 8 to 9 schools, but what do you think were the positive impacts of studies in your career?
It's a very necessary part, I would say, and it is every player should study. It makes you sharper, I feel. It makes you more intelligent. It makes you to think more. So I think studies is a necessary part, and it definitely can be managed together with sports, because one can practice around 5 to 6 hours a day or maybe 7 hours. But then you already have, you can at least take out 1 hour for your studies in a day. And that's what I have learned all these years. And I never spent my time going out with friends during that time, because I never had time. My schedule was always packed, and I never had to go for tuitions. I was quite good at studies and I like to study. So there are many people who feel that the tuitions are necessary, but I never felt the need of it. Mm-hmm. And also time management is the key. That's right. What I have been putting a lot of emphasis on. That's a very key part. You need to stop using excess of social media. Social media is important, but you need to have the right amount of time on that, the right amount of watching of TV. You don't need to attend a lot of parties or social functions or family functions. I never used to be going to the family functions or social parties or any kind of that stuff. So that's how I could manage my time well. I could give a lot of time to the productive things. So that has helped me to grow as a player well and as a person well.
Right, right. So yeah, there are many positive impacts. Though negative impacts, if we don't count, there are many positive impacts of studies in a sportsman's career. So, what do you think is your fitness mantra? I mean, how do you keep yourself fit during such epidemics?
I have some of the equipments back home, but it's not complete one, I would say. Because I always go to the gym if I need something, or I am still not able to run much because I like to run and I live close to the beach, so I always go to run to my beach nearby, and that's what I do a lot of times. But right now I am able to keep a schedule. I have a proper schedule discussed with my coach in Germany, so I always follow my schedule, and also I always try to have the right food, right amount of calories, not have much of sugar. So that's what I try to do, because doing all the fitness, and then if you eat a lot of junk food, a lot of sugars, a lot of calories, then all the workout is in vain. So I think you need to have the right balance. You need to have the proper intake of food, so that you can also keep yourself fit. And this is a very important juncture where I'm not able to train 5 to 6 hours a day, what I normally do. So I need to keep myself fit for the post-lockdown period. Because if I can't get unfit or a bit fat, it will be really difficult for me to get back to the game, where I might get slow and I might get a little bit bulky, and that's not advisable, and it might make a very big difference to my level of table tennis.
Right, yeah. So I mean, at least investing some time during the day and keeping yourself stick to your diet, that's what your fitness mantra would be, right? So during this shutdown or lockdown, what all things do you do that keeps you motivated during such time? I mean, how do you keep yourself motivated?
I have been quite positive, and also during this lockdown there are few negatives, but I think there are more positive things that I have got, because I have never been able to spend quality time with my family, and this is the time around after 10 or 11 years I have been able to stay for such a long time at home to be with my parents.
And also
this was the first Mother's Day couple of days back, after 11-12 years to be with my mother. So I'm enjoying the time, and also I'm able to do lot of skills, like I said, that apart from table tennis, I'm able to do a lot of other things right now. And I'm also in touch with practice table tennis. If I would be away from table tennis, I would have been really feeling a bit, I would say, depressed about staying away from the sport. But I am still able to play here. So there are a lot of positive things about the lockdown right now. And it's very necessary for everyone of us to stay at home during such a pandemic and to fight against the coronavirus. So I think it's the right thing to do right now, and sooner or later we will get to go out and we will be able to fight this whole thing.
So lastly, any message you have to give it to all the youngsters and young table tennis players who are right now sitting at their home doing some of the other stuff?
Yeah, I would just like to tell everyone that everyone should try to follow whatever they like to do. They should try to build their career into it. I like to play table tennis, and my parents supported me, so that's really important for all the parents out there to support their kids where their talent is, where their passion is. and not forcing them to do what they want, what the parents want, or what the other people think of doing it. So that's very important, and also it is very important to stay true to yourself and also have discipline, dedication, determination. 3 D's, that's what I call it. And also have a lot of patience. Sometimes many players or many people working towards their goal don't find the success too early. So you need to have the right patience. You need to work for hours, for days, for years maybe. And then you might find success after a few years, and then everything might seem that the sacrifices you have done has come fruitful.
Right. So just keep patience and keep moving with what comes. I mean, just go with the flow.
Yeah.
Right.
I would like to give one example. Like the Taj Mahal took around 25 years to build.
Right.
And a normal monument or a normal building takes just 1 year or 6 months or something. So it's always like this. And for in my case too, around it took 20 years to get the Arjun Award.
Right.
So it's sometimes like that. And you need to accept that. You need to just keep working towards your goal and with dedication, determination, and discipline.
Right. Great, Harmit. Thank you so much for joining us and giving some time from your busy schedule. And I hope everything gets back on track as soon as possible. And and we get to see you back on court playing for India.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Thank you so much.